Dearly beloved, we are gathered together here in the sight of God and in the presence of these witnesses to join together Sean and Jessica in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted of God and signifying unto us the mystical union which exists between Christ and his church, which holy estate Christ adorned and beautified with his presence in Cana of Galilee. It is therefore not to be entered into unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy estate, these two persons come now to be joined. If any man can show just cause why they may not lawfully be joined together, let him now speak, or else hereafter forever hold his peace. I cry and charge you both, as you stand in the presence of God, before whom the secrets of all hearts are disclosed, that having duly considered the holy covenant you are about to make, you do now declare before this company your pledge of faith, each to the other. Be well sure that if these solemn vows are kept inviolate as God's word demands, and if steadfastly you endeavor to do the will of your heavenly Father, God will bless your marriage, will grant you fulfillment in it, and will establish your home in peace. Sean, wilt thou have this woman to be thy wedded wife, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony? Wilt thou love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto her, so long as you both shall live? So say, I will.
I will.
Jessica, wilt thou have this man to be thy wedded husband, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony? Wilt thou love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto him, so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Now, who gives this woman to be married to this man? You all may be seated. Now repeat after me. I, Sean, take thee, Jessica.
I, Sean, take thee, Jessica.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto.
And thereto.
I pledge thee my faith.
I pledge thee my faith.
I, Jessica,
take
thee, Sean, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death us do part, according to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I pledge thee my faith. This time, Sean and Jessica are going to do the sand ceremony. So I'm going to step out of your way and invite you to go back. We celebrate the groom and bride's union as it's symbolized through the pouring of two individual containers of sand. One represents Sean and all that he is, all that he was and all that he ever will be. The other represents Jessica and all that she was, all that she is, and all that she ever will be. As the two vials of sand are poured into the third vase, the individual container of sand will no longer exist, as they will be joined together as one. Just as these grains of sand can never be separated and poured again into individual vases, so will the love and bond between the two render them inseparable. Therefore, what God has joined together, let not man separate. The wedding ring is an outward and a visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace, signifying to all the uniting of this man and this woman in holy matrimony through the Church of Jesus Christ our Lord. Though small in size, these rings are large in significance. Made of precious metal, they remind us that love is not cheap nor common. Indeed, love may cost us dearly. Made in a circle, their design tells us that love must never come to an end. We must keep it continuous. As you wear these rings, whether together or apart for a moment, may they be constant reminders of these glad promises you have made to one another today. Let us pray. Bless, O Lord, the giving of these rings, that they who wear them may abide in your peace and continue in your favor through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
Of our constant faith.
Of our constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I be wed.
I be wed.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
And repeat after me. Token and pledge
of
our constant faith
and
abiding love. With this ring, I be wed in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. For as much as Jessica and Sean have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God in this company, and thereto have pledged their faith each to the other and have declared the same by joining hands and by giving and receiving rings, I pronounce that they are husband and wife together. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, those whom God hath joined together, let no man put asunder. Amen. You can hold hands if you want. Now let us pray. Eternal God, creator and preserver of all humankind, giver of all spiritual grace, the author of everlasting life, send your blessing upon Sean and Jessica, whom we bless in your name, that they may surely perform and keep the vows and covenant between them made, and may ever remain in perfect love and peace together, and live according to your laws. Look graciously upon them, that they may love, honor, and cherish each other, and so live together in faithfulness and patience, in wisdom and true godliness, that their home may be a haven of blessing and a place of peace. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now may God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord graciously with his favor look upon you and so fill you with all spiritual benediction and love that you may live together in this life, that in the world to come you may have life everlasting. Amen. I invite you to turn and face the congregation. May I introduce to you for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Sean McDonald.